Angelus.
Yep.
That
says.
Yeah.
So, anyway, what we've done is just put your foot up. What we're here for is just to have an informal chat, okay, about your mum. And now your name now, of course, is Edna Reece.
Yeah.
But originally you were Canning.
Yes.
Okay. And how many children were there? It was the six children, wasn't it?
You know, there were seven.
Seven, of course,
and Olive died when she was 11 years old.
Olive died. And which order were you? You were the second?
I was the second. It was Len, then me.
Right.
Then George. Then it was Olive. Then it was Eileen, Audrey, and Howard.
Howard, the baby.
He was the baby.
I think you still call him the baby, don't you?
I can see him going around with curls now. He's almost 7 years old with curls, don't you? Ringlets.
So which year were you born?
1921.
Seems a while ago now, yeah?
That's true.
It does.
I wish it was later than that,
Steve. a lot of stuff has passed under the bridge since then.
My God, yeah.
So at the moment you're living in 51 Beach House, isn't it? In Whitchurch.
Yeah. It's very nice here, so I gotta be fair. It's very pleasant, you know.
Yeah.
I gotta
and of course
be.
You've lived in quite a few places, haven't you?
Yeah.
Years. So which house were you living in when you were first born?
75 Clarence Embankment.
Clarence Embankment?
Yeah.
Oh no, you see I didn't know that.
Didn't you?
I thought there was Seven Grove, and before that there was something, wasn't there? Before Seven Grove?
No, that was after Seven Grove. I got married from Seven Grove.
Right. So you were in Clarence Embankment?
I was born at Aunt Lynn was in Clarence Embankment. 75 Clarence Embankment.
Oh, right.
You can see it now.
Yeah. So had your mum and dad lived there long?
Well, I was only young, but I think they were there long. Because after that, when they were in there, it was a small house really, and they moved next door to 77.
Oh, did they?
Yeah, they lived there, and it was a corner house. It was very big.
Oh, right.
It was a big house that was much bigger than the one before. That house is gone now. They've taken that 77 now.
Oh.
It's not there anymore.
So do you remember much about a Clarence Embankment?
Yeah, Mum used to take wash in it.
Did she?
Yeah, she had a machine. Mama, anything going, Mum always had it first.
Oh.
And she had this big electric washing machine, she did. And Olen and I used to go and collect the washing. We had it. Mum had the wicker basket, you know. And Mum and Len and I used to go and get the washing off the people.
Off the neighbours?
Yeah, whoever, yes.
Oh, right.
She used to do that off. She used to be there nearly all day, our mum did.
Yeah.
And I used to see to Eileen, because she had Eileen as well.
Oh,
she had Eileen as a baby.
Oh, she was the baby then. She would look after her.
And I think I was about the first one to give Eileen her pharic rusks.
Oh, right.
You know, feed off a spoon.
Because you were 9 years older
than
Eileen, weren't you?
Yes.
She was born in 1930.
Was it?
Yeah, 1930. You were 21. 1921, did you say?
Yes.
Yeah,
yes.
So you're 9 years older. So you were given the job of looking after her.
Oh, I loved it.
Yeah.
I was like mother there, you know.
Right.
And of course, we had a gramophone and the records and everything, and we used to play this. Mum used to be out there doing the washing.
Oh, right.
And we'd be in here, very big rooms they were. And Mum was only, she could see us, like, you know, through here.
Mm.
And we'd play the old gramophone.
And the wind-up one?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, with the big horn coming out. Yeah, for the sound to come out.
Oh, that was posh, that, wasn't it? We didn't have one of the horn. That was his master's voice, and we didn't have that.
Oh, right.
It was an ordinary square one, you know.
Oh, right.
And we used to play the records on there.
Yeah.
We did. Look after our Eileen. I never forget when Mum had Eileen. She was in the front room, and the bed was there, and came down. And I forget now, Dad came up and said, come and see what we got, present we got, what a surprise we got for you. I forget now. Anyhow, I came downstairs, and Mum had this baby. Oh, God, and of course, it was Mum's birthday on the 2nd, or Eileen's on the 3rd.
Of course, yes, they.
So Mum said, this is what the stock brought me, she said, for my birthday. And Eileen didn't have a name properly then, you see, so she brought me this baby. So I said, oh, Mum, can she be on my birthday? Mum said, no, she said she was only born just after my birthday. And, well, why can I? Couldn't see why she couldn't be on my birthday as well.
All right.
Yeah, it was funny, wasn't it? What do you think of that age? Why can't she be? I was a bit upset about that because she couldn't be on my birthday.
Yeah.
But...
Because it's strange that the thoughts you have when you're nine.
That's it, you know, yeah.
About babies and things like that, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, we almost brought her Eileen up, Len and I. Yeah, we did. Yeah.
So your mother, which her name was Dorothea, wasn't it?
Dorothea
Rose.
Dorothea Rose.
Yeah. She would take in the washing from all the neighbours.
Yeah, and then,
Why didn't the women do their own washing?
Mum used to have this basket, you know, the big baskets, you know.
Yeah.
And Mum would do that for 1 and 6.
1 and 6?
Yeah, when I was getting up.
So would she iron it as well?
Oh, no.
Oh, just the washing?
They had to dry it as well.
You take it back to them wet?
Oh, yeah, you take it back to them wet.
So that's different from now, isn't it? If people have their stuff, then they expect it to come back ironed and on a hanger.
Oh, no. Mum always washed it and... Then I had to take it back.
And that's because she had a washing machine?
Mum had a washing machine. Nobody else had one, of course.
Oh, right.
Mum always had it. When the electric irons came out, they were a guinea then. And our mum had one before anybody.
Oh, right.
And when perms came out, I remember mum having a perm, never knew anybody else had had one, but mum had anything that came out first, our mum always had it.
Oh, right.
Yeah, she did.
So what was your earliest recollection in Clarence Road?
Clarence Embankment.
Clarence Embankment, sorry, yeah. What was your earliest recollection in that house?
I know when I was a kid in the babies, and I didn't want to go to school. And I think it was all Lena came back and took me to school. And I didn't want to go. I was playing up and there's a long street Clarence Embankment.
Oh, right.
And anyhow, he takes me across. I go across the road by there, by the bridge. And I don't know if a bike hit me or something anyhow. And whose tram was there? It was Dad's.
Oh, right.
Yeah, it was our dad. And of course the driver, you know, recognised us, like, you know. And anyhow, I went to school. But I wasn't very happy about it, I can tell you. I played it all the way with Ollie. And then when we were in the top school, Len and I were always in the same class. And of course, when we had the exams, I was top and Len was bottom.
Oh,
nice. And I remember Miss Benson, the old teacher. I forget what it was. She was on Olen's side or something. And she said, and don't you hit Len on the way home. I'm telling you, don't you hit Len on the way home. So, no, I wanted him. And when I go outside the school, I remember I came as ever on Len.
Yeah. But he was older than you, wasn't he?
Oh, yeah, he says he was older than me, yeah.
All right.
Oh, yeah.
So which school was that then?
Clarence Road.
Oh, Clarence Road.
It's not there now.
Oh, right.
No, it's not there now. It's gone.
Yeah. Right. Everything's gone.
Everything, that's true. All those memories are gone. And my uncle, Dad's brother, he had a shed on the bottom. And I don't know why, but it was by Curran's then, modern Curran's then. I don't know what it was, but anyhow, he had this shed. And I used to go down and see Uncle George. And he'd have a mug there. On a round stove thing, and always had tea in it, and talking to him. And he said, for your birthday, he said, I'm going to give you a silver new nothing. Well, it came my birthday, and he never gave it to me. And I remember saying to Mum or Dad, Uncle George said he was going to give me a silver new nothing for my birthday. And I'd been down and I'd seen him, and he never said anything about it.
Yeah.
So, of course, then they told me what it was. I was so disappointed because I never had a silver new nothing.
Of course, your mum carried that through for all of her life, didn't she? Because saying silver new nothing.
Oh, yeah.
Because I can remember her saying to me as
that's
well,
right.
You know, oh, yes, I'm going to get you a silver new nothing and things like that. So.
Very disappointed if you don't know.
Yeah, that's
it
right.
It is, yes.
It sounds good, but...
Yeah, that's true.
So, you mentioned your father, who was, of course, Richard
Dad.
Yeah.
I can see our dad now. When we lived on Clans Embankment, he always looked smart, my father did, and always cleaned his uniform and his buttons and everything. Right. You know. He had a thing, you know, from the army, and he'd put all his buttons in there, like, you know, and clean his buttons, his cap, everything. Dad was spotless going to work. He always looked lovely. And I can see my father now, although I was small, he was small. And I can see him now running, because my father always ran everywhere, you know. And I can see my father now running to work, you know.
Yeah. And what was he doing then?
He was on the trams.
On the trams.
Mm. He was on the trams when George.
Yeah.
I think it was just after George was born. He went on the trams. He was a long time. He was there until he retired.
Right. Yes. Of course. Mm. Yeah. Because working on the trams then was quite a good job, wasn't it?
Oh God, yeah. You know, and I remember wages never used to go up and down, and his wages used to be £2.17 and 6 a week.
Was it?
Yeah, and that was for donkey's years. That never ever altered.
Yeah.
No, never altered.
£2.17 and 6.
And
did your parents talk about money like that? Like you knew what his wages were. Now people tend not to talk about their wages and things
this. No.
But they obviously talked to you about it.
Obviously knew it. I don't know why, but we just knew it, you know.
Ah, right. I mean, maybe it was because it was had the same wage for so long.
Yeah. Possibly. I mean, we weren't interested, really. You know?
No.
We weren't a bit interested.
Mm.
But so I don't know. But I always knew that Dad had £2.17 and 6 a week, and that was a long time.
Doesn't sound good much money, now, but good money then.
It was good money, yeah, it really was.
So what was he doing before he worked on the trams?
Well, I don't know.
No?
He was a shoemaker.
Of course, yes.
He made his own shoes to get married in.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, that's true.
And his two brothers were shoemakers as well. Uncle George and Uncle Jim were shoemakers.
Oh, right.
And Dad made his own shoes to get married in. And he always made his own clogs for the garden.
Oh, right. So he wore clogs, not shoes.
No, he wore clogs.
Oh, right.
Yeah. You wore clogs to the garden, like. Mm.
So I presume that wasn't a very very good pay making shoes. So he decided to go on the trams. Is it a better job?
Well, I don't really know that. Like, you know, I was too young for that. And I don't even remember him starting on the trams.
No.
Because he always had his allotments in any case.
Yes, of course.
Because Mum even sold the veg from the garden.
Oh, did she?
Yeah, Mum. I can see it there now in this big room in 77 Clans Embankment. And she had the big scales there. And she'd have I'm not quite sure if it was a sack. No, it must have been a sack of potatoes. Potatoes, anyhow. And she had the cabbage and lettuce and all that. And Len and I, George did it on very latter late times. But Len and I used to go to the garden helping Dad. Our Len had a track. You notice our Len's hands.
All right.
He had he used to wheel a truck up.
All right.
He used to park it across the road from the school and then pick it up and go up Dunballs Road.
You're right.
Yeah, go up Dunballs Road.
Is that where the allotment was?
The allotments were up there. He'd have to go right round, like, you know, to by Tristan Incline Terrace and go down and under the bridge to the garden. Right. But Dad used to cut across the railway line, you know. He shouldn't have, but he did.
I can imagine saying, old trains are. Just like he did.
He had the door there, no, he'd open the door and shut it after him, you know. Mm. And good luck, and then off we go. And did I give you a biscuit?
Yeah, no, they're over there. I'll have one after. So your mum used to sell the veg from the front room?
Yeah, from the front room in 77 Clans Embankment.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So because later on in life, of course, she had the shop, didn't she?
Yeah.
In Grangetown.
This was many years before that, man.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, because Len and I, and on the end, George used to be there as well.
Mm.
We'd have a big pram, and we lived in Ely. No, wait a minute. No, I'm going beyond myself. No, this because when Mum sold the veg, we were in 77 Clarence Embankment.
Right. So this is the second move.
Yeah. I was next door.
Next door, yeah.
And we lived in 3 houses in Clarence Embankment. We lived in 61 and all that was a huge house, the biggest house in Clarence Embankment.
Oh, right.
My mother was always on the move.
Yes.
We always said she'd have a caravan, and I forget when we came home, wherever we'd been, and there's a caravan. Yeah. Can't believe it.
Wasn't there one time when she just came home and announced that she's bought another house?
Well, there was nothing there, wasn't it?
Yeah.
She used to go on the agents all the time.
Yeah. Oh, right.
Mama never settled.
Yeah.
And anyhow, yeah, Mum used to sell the veg there.
Oh, right.
And they used to come to the house, like, you know, for yeah. And all, yeah.
And all the neighbours, of course, would know that your mum sold the,
oh, yeah,
the stuff,
yeah.
And they'd just knock on the door and come in.
Yes, yeah.
Oh, right.
Yeah. Yeah,
so she did that for a number of years, I presume, did she?
Yeah. So we left there.
Yeah.
And then, I don't know where we went from there. She moved so many times, I forget. And, I know, where were we to when we used to go and sell a mint and all? Well, that was in Clarence Embankment. Dad grew the mint, and we used to, on Friday nights then, Ellen and I would be there, and we'd bunch the mints up. You know, bunches, like, you know, penny a bunch.
Yeah.
And then we used to go Saturday morning then and sell it, penny a bunch. And do you know, if we had one bunch left, we'd never come home.
Oh, right.
Oh no, you wouldn't. If there's one bench left, you wouldn't sell it for nothing or anything.
Yeah.
You wouldn't come on till that one went.
Right, and where did you sell that, you say?
Down the docks.
Down the docks?
Yeah, down Esplanade Way. Yeah.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
So you just stand out on the Esplanade, eh?
Yeah, we knocked at doors and...
Oh, knocked doors
we
as well,
knocked
yeah.
at doors, you wouldn't even just yes or no, like, you know.
Mm.
It was a bonus if it was yes, like, you know. Yeah, it was some because they very well to do. Those people were that then, you know.
Of course,
it was different
yeah.
now, but
yeah.
it was then.
Mm.
And we used to sell them in then. And when did we used to... we lived in Ely then when we used to take the big carriage down to Victoria Parkway. And there's Ethel Street and all those streets there. And we'd have flowers, lettuce, cabbage in there. And we used to go knocking houses there. Did they want any veg? Yeah.
So did you get something for doing that? Or was it just, you just come home and just give the money to your parents?
Just give the money to mum.
Yeah.
I mean,
you didn't get anything for it.
I think we used to have a penny sometimes.
Oh, was it?
Yeah.
Oh, right.
I think we used to have a penny.
Yeah.
It wasn't 8p, it was a penny.
Oh.
Wonderful. Yeah, okay. You wouldn't spend it all at once, I can tell you.
Yeah. So going back to Clarence Road School there, what do you remember about the school there? Because that must have been your first school. Was it primary school?
Oh, yes.
Primary school.
In the infants, yeah. We started in the infants and finished.
Yeah. So do you have many memories of that school? Did you enjoy it?
Oh, yes, yes, yeah.
Yeah?
And I remember down in the infants, on Christmas time, they used to give the children presents, and I was hoping they'd give me one of these with the beads on, you know?
Oh, yes.
Oh, it was
like an abacus.
Yeah.
For counting. And,
yeah.
And so, oh, right.
And I remember down the infants, I can't remember much of it, but I remember down the infants, it was like I had that.
Right.
And I remember once, Miss Daniel, I think it was, and I was there. Edna, she said, don't keep doing that. You're a very pretty girl, and you're going to spoil your face. And I thought, I don't know, can I spoil my face? Dan used to knock me, and how can I spoil my face by doing that, you know? Don't do it now, Edna. You're a pretty girl. You spoil your face.
And that was the teacher saying that.
Miss Daniel or Daniel, but something like that. I can see her now doing it. It was front of her. Yeah.
So there you had just a form teacher, and that they would teach you all day, and they teach you all the different subjects.
Yes, that was the infants. Then we went upstairs then to the big school.
Oh, it's above. It's just above stairs.
Yeah,
on
we
second
had to
go
up the stairs. Right. Yeah, that was the big school.
Oh.
And. tell you. Not about her.
So you still had forms then, though, did you? You still stayed in the same classroom?
No.
You had different subjects then, and you would go to different teachers?
No. It was all in our classroom.
All in that classroom.
And then when we went back after the holidays, after August holidays, you got the next class. And you get everything there. Not going out like they do now.
Right.
Not like that. It was all in the classroom.
It's all in that one classroom. And the teachers would come to you then?
That's right, yes.
Oh, right.
Different teachers. Mm. Say a Welsh teacher and things like that. Right. I hated Welsh.
Yes, I think I did as well.
Yeah, I hated it.
So did you enjoy that secondary school then, isn't it?
No, it was still there was no secondary school then.
Oh, right.
We finished up in Standard 7.
Oh, right.
But so I left there before that.
Right. So what age would you have to stay there to?
14.
14?
Yeah.
But you actually left before 14, did you?
No, Mum moved to Ely.
Oh, right.
And then I had to go to school in Herbert Thompson's.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
What was your address in Ely? Can you remember that?
56 Phyllis Crescent.
Oh, Phyllis Crescent. Yeah. Oh, right.
And Dad had a gardens there. He had a lot, there was a lot of them, like alongside us. And Dad had the one there.
Mm.
He used to, I forget now if he had other allotments as well, but I know he had that one there.
Mm. So how long did you spend in Herbert Thompson School? Was that just a couple of years left? Or?
No, not a long time.
Mm-hmm. When you moved from the one school
Clarence
to...
Clarence Road.
From Clarence Road to there. Yeah. Obviously, you had to leave all your friends behind there, in your class friends and things like this. And
when we moved from Clarence Road, we went to Kitcher's mother, Auntie Flory. There was Auntie Flory, Auntie Daisy, and Auntie Emmy. They had three houses together.
Oh, right.
And we went down there to live for 6 months so his mum could get a house in Ely.
Oh, right.
She's mad, she used to move all the time.
Oh, right. So she actually sold the house before she moved?
No, not her own. It wasn't her own. You never owned your own house then.
Oh, right.
Or the people didn't. I remember Winnie, she owned her house. God, that was. Oh.
Ah. So you just used to rent the house?
Oh, rent them, yeah.
Oh, right.
Yeah, we used to rent them then.
Oh.
And.
So you went to that house in the meantime. Did you say with Kitches in Ely?
No, in the Dunnet Docks.
Oh, right.
George Street.
Yeah.
You're not there now. And we went down there and lived for 6 months. And the funniest thing is, I stayed in Auntie Flory's, which was Kitches' mother. And I used to have to sleep with Kitch.
Oh, right.
And, I mean, he was big, he was, like,
yeah.
You know, because he used to go out, like, you know.
Yeah.
And I remember once Grampy, or I love Grampy, my father-in-law, and he was going to work this night, and Nana was next door having a drink. She was like a dipper. And... Grampy was going, and I'm there, like, you know. And now he said, shall I leave this wireless on for you, he said, because I'm going to work. He said, all right, now I'll leave this wireless on. So I said, yeah. And he left it on, and I never forget, not long after he went out, suddenly foreign come on it. I was scared stiff. Oh, God, I was frightened. I went out on the front door, and I thought, oh, God.
Mm.
I was so frightened because it was foreign on there because I'd never seen one of these Wallaces around me before.
Oh, right.
And I was scared stiff. Oh, I loved him.
Yeah.
I loved Grampy. I really did.
What was his name?
Uncle Sam.
Sam?
Yeah.
Oh, right.
Uncle Sam.
Yeah.
Oh, I really loved him.
Yeah.
I did. And he liked me too.
And he treated you well, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, right.
He was very kind to me.
Yeah.
Very, very kind to me.
Oh, that's good.
His daughter... Flory, there was some warrant dispute or something. Or she was going with this chap or something next door. And he didn't believe in it. No, Nana, never. And so, of course, there was a riff there.
Mm.
And I was very much, I was short like her and I was like her. And I go down this hall, dead hall, it was right down the backyard, right down the end. And I go down, I come up, he said, God, you don't have to remind me of how flurry you do. Mm. Always used to, always did. I felt sorry for him, I really did. Mm. But there you are.
So your mother and father, you know, they obviously loved each other very much.
My mother and father, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. What do you remember about their relationship? You know, like, people, did people show affection to each other then? You know, is that the, did you get that sort of impression?
No.
You know, were they holding each other much,
no.
Hugging each other much?
No.
Yeah?
No.
Right.
They never rowed or anything like that.
No.
Dad always called my mother kid.
Oh, did he?
Always called her kid.
Oh,
always.
Right. So what would your mother call your father? Was it always Dick?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Or Dad. Dick, or, when we were older, like, you know, the kids.
Oh, right.
It was either Dick or Dad.
Yeah.
But they were very happy together. They never ever rowed or argued anything. At least we never ever seen anything.
No.
No.
But they had a very happy, harmonious relationship.
They did, yes. Yeah. Yes.
And then obviously it came through into their children. You know, if you have a happy relationship
that.
You know, your children are
usually, that's true.
More well-balanced.
Oh, they had good parents, very good parents, and hard-working they were as well.
Yeah, yeah.
Very hard-working.
Because your father just never stopped, did he?
No.
No, even the time that I knew him, he was just always on the go. You'd never see, I don't think I ever saw him sitting down.
No, that's true, you wouldn't.
Mm.
No.
Very good. So you had... you moved to Ely. When did Seven Grove come in?
When did Seven Grove come? We went to Ely to 24 Chartres Road, first of all. Lovely house on Chartres Road. And these people in... I can't remember the street we were in now. Chartres Road, Phyllis Crescent.
Yeah.
Wanted to change.
Oh, right.
Houses. We could do that then. Because her daughter had rheumatics, and it was a concrete house.
Oh, right.
Mam is a changer for Mam.
Yeah.
Wonderful. She was there on the spot.
Yeah.
Mam changes. And then, next thing, Olive had the had rheumatic.
Yes.
Heart. And, Oliver rheumatic heart, and she was in hospital, I don't forget now, 10 or 11 months, and she died.
Yeah.
And she, Olive said to Mum, Eileen Audrey Howard was outside, they couldn't go in the hospital, but there she was, she could see her through the window, like, you know. And she said, you watch our Eileen, you watch Eileen. And you know, one long after that, Eileen went to Dulwich House.
Yeah.
In Pencisley Road.
Yeah.
And she was there for a few months.
Yeah.
But she still had a heart trouble, like, you know.
Oh, right.
But,
yeah, of course. How old was Olive when she died?
11.
11.
She was 11 on the 16th. She was 11 on the 16th of November. She died on the 25th and got buried on the 30th.
Oh, right.
Yeah. And that's the last time I ever seen a horse and cart funeral.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
Yeah, they had a horse and cart, did
horse
they?
Horse and cart, yeah.
Oh, that's good.
The last time I ever seen them.
Yes, you don't see them anymore.
No.
Because
they didn't go to funerals then like they do now.
No.
I mean, no.
Of course, that must be very traumatic for your parents and so on. They...
It was, yeah.
You also lived in Cavaillon.